So, this was the remedy for men. Now, cure for women. Those women whose eggs remain underdeveloped, or it does not mature properly, fails to reach its maturity, they should take Shivlingi, seeds of Putra Jivak, seeds of Shivlingi, break the seeds of Putra Jivak, break the seeds of Putra Jivak and take out its nut. Take seeds of Shivlingi, 100 gram, nuts of Putra Jivak, 100 gram. From 3 to 400 grams of seeds, you will get 100 grams of nut. So take 100 grams of Shivlingi seeds and 100 grams Putra Jivak, nuts 100 grams. Grind them to a fine powder, mix them and take 1 gram each twice a day in the morning and in the evening with cow's milk. This will help prevent untimely abortions, that is abortion at premature stage, when the embryo is just 2 to 3 months old and it gets suddenly aborted. There are many reasons for this too. One should avoid overindulgence. Couples with such tendency for lust slowly may become unable to reproduce and have children. Women who remain excited have a tendency for overindulgence. They may also have to face sex-related problems. Similarly, men should also avoid being overindulgent. After all, lust is not the ultimate aim of life. The sole aim of married couples should be to reproduce. Love has no room for lust, as lust destroys love. It shakes the foundation of love. What strengthens love is the devotion, the dedication, good behavior, mutual understanding, fulfilling one's duty, communication, and feeling of mutual concern. So this is specially meant for women. Shivlingi and nuts of Putra Jivak. Seeds of Shivlingi and nuts of Putra Jivak. Shivlingi are seeds only and nuts of Putra Jivak. Powder them and mix them together. Take 1 gram each in the morning and evening on an empty stomach. And in the evening at 4 or 5 o'clock or after dinner with milk, it can be taken. Take on an empty stomach in the morning and again on an empty stomach in the evening at 4 or 5 o'clock. Or else take this powder of Shivlingi seeds and Putra Jivak nuts at night before you go to bed. This is specially for women. Now women have many other problems as well. For underdeveloped eggs, they should be taking powdered mixture of white muesli, shatavar and ashwagandha in the dose of 2 to 3 grams. In addition to this, there are a few more remedies specially for them. Those who are suffering from problem of uterus should take 1 spoonful of phalagrit or panchakavya grit. 1 spoonful. Panchakavya grit or phalagrit. Both of these subside the problems related to uterus or ovary. Those with closed tubes will also benefit, but they will have to practice pranayam compulsorily. Otherwise also we have seen that even without taking white muesli, shatavari and ashwagandha and also Putra Jivak and Shivlingi and also without using phalagrit or panchakavya grit or even stri rasayan, just by practicing pranayam, 15 to 20 minutes practice of Kapalabhati, 15 to 20 minutes practice of Anulom Vilom, one experiences major improvement. Bhastrika Kapalabhati Bahi Anulom Vilom Brahmari Udgit and meditation on Om. These are the 7 pranayam. With the practice of these, those with closed fallopian tubes experience major improvement. It's a drastic improvement. In addition to this, fibroids of uterus, cyst of ovary may also dissolve. They may disappear without any operation. Operation may sometimes be very harmful also. So much so that you suffer throughout your life and have to be operated repeatedly, and finally one may become unable to reproduce forever. You will not be in a position to bear a child. Try this out. It may take from 3 to 6 months. 3 to 6 months. Maximum it may take 1 year. For someone it may take 1 month or 2 or 3 months, or a few may take 6 months to get pregnant. You must practice the pranayam and take medicines told by us. Now, those women who experience heavy bleeding in periods should take stri rasayan. Stri rasayan, phalagrit, also Shivlingi and Putra Jivak. Those with very heavy periods may take 1 tablet each of stri rasayan and may drink the extract of shisham leaves, which will check the heating effect, and this will help control the problem of overbleeding and white discharge may subside as well. Now for those having very low bleeding in the menstrual cycle, those women with very less period should take Dashmul Kwat, 1 spoonful in the morning and evening after boiling it. Dashmul Kwat, 1 spoonful each after the morning breakfast and after the dinner. Though Dashmul Arishta is commonly available in the market, but its medicinal value is just for namesake. It is just the sweet extract of a few things in water. Preparations are hardly made with honesty these days. Dashmul Kwat. Boiled extract of various herbs. It is more effective. To those having less period, 1 or 2 tablets of Raja Pravartini Vati can also be taken twice a day. It's for those with very less period. Few don't get it at all. If such is the case, then also practice pranayama. Your hormonal system may improve drastically and menstrual cycle will start. Even the heavy period may become normal with pranayama. Pranayama is responsible for maintaining a balance in our body, a hormonal balance. As a result, the irregular systems become regular. I had mentioned earlier that sexual diseases are mainly related to pituitary gland and thyroid glands. Both of these glands become healthy with pranayama and everything becomes normal. So, women with low period should take Dashmul Kwat and Raja Pravartini Vati, 1 or 2 tablets twice a day in morning and evening, along with 1 spoonful of Dashmul Kwat twice a day. You have to continue taking Shivlingi and Putra Jeevak. There is one more problem. Although it is seen very rarely among women, even before the first pregnancy, in rare cases, we have seen that 10 to 12 year girl child may develop fibroids in uterus and cyst in ovary, though it's very rare. But what is the solution of such cases? Now, cases like closed tubes improve with the practice of Anulom Vilom and Kapalabhati Pranayam. And powdered mixture of Shivlingi and Putra Jeevak is also very helpful under such conditions. But what is the cure for fibroids? There is a cyst in the uterus, in the ovary. For this, there is an Ayurvedic preparation which will help. Though with the practice of pranayama, only the fibroids of uterus, cyst of ovary may dissolve to the extent of 100%. But sometimes ladies do not have so much of patience. Actually, they have a psychology that with some oral medicine, they will be able to improve fast. Though pranayama will help you improve a lot. And if you have faith in me, then first practice pranayama only. After a regular practice of 3 months, if the ovarian cyst does not dissolve, the overgrowth does not disappear, then only you take medicines. Otherwise, there is no need of taking any medicine. What you have to do? Take 1 tablet each of Kanchanar Gugul and Vriddhi Vatika Vati after the meals. And then Tamra Bhasma 1 gram, Mukta Shukti Bhasma 5 gram, Praval Pishti 10 grams, Amrita Sat 10 gram, and Shila Sindur in the dose of 2 to 4 grams. Those with weak physique should take 2 grams. Those with medium physique should take 3 grams. And those with healthy physique, with normal weight and completely healthy body, can take 4 grams of Shila Sindur. So take 4 grams Shila Sindur, then Amrita Sat 10 gram, Praval Pishti 10 gram, Mukta Shukti Bhasma 5 gram, Tamra Bhasma 1 gram. These are the main ingredients. Mix them and divide in 60 parts. Take each part twice a day with honey on empty stomach. With this, fibroids of uterus and ovarian cyst may dissolve on their own. So these were few of the Ayurvedic remedies for women for their different reproductive problem. So these are few of our suggestions.